Hi everyone, and welcome to the fifth episode of Making Marble Machine X. And today we are talking about making plywood gears with high precision, such as this one. This is one of the larger gears on the Marble Machine X, and it has 112 teeth, and it has a track for lifting marbles at a later point. So this gear will do two jobs for the price of one part, so to speak. We also choose to offset the gear teeth. So the gear is consisting of two layers of plywood, and we have offset the gear teeth by half a tooth, as you saw there, for smoother power transmission between the meshing gears. This is the steel frame that you saw us build last week. And here you can see how everything goes on top of the steel frame. And these are only placeholders in this CAD drawing, because to use the real gears in the CAD is too CPU and graphics intensive. And here I am making the same gear for the first marble machine. So this is some years ago, and as you can see, I printed out like 18 A4 papers, glued them together, and there was some printer errors, so the pattern didn't even add up. So I think you can see that here. You see the pattern doesn't even up. The circle is not round even. So actually these hand cut gears, they did work. They were not the major issue with the machine. And we were using Mattias Vandals gear generator program, which we are still using on the new marble machine actually. It's a wonderful piece of software. So we're still using the gear generator from Mattias Vandal to generate the templates for these gears. So down to the left, you can see the gear we're working on today. So we needed a way to improve on the gear manufacturing for the Marble Machine X. And the machine you see in front of you right now is called the CNC machine. So with the CNC machine, we can design the gears in the computer and have them digitally cut out. Just that's what how we did this design actually. I'm standing behind the plywood there and waving the LED LED lights to make that shiny effect. This is the gear. This is the gear in the CAM software, and we're sending the code for the gear to the CNC machine here. So this is the CNC machine cutting the gear. And we made a lot of mistakes. So what we're using for bit, we're using a down cutting spiral bit, and that had some issues that you will see later. It looks better there than what it actually ended up to be. So on the shaft we need some flanges to hold the gear. You can see the keyway there. Here I'm filing out the keyway manually. And these flanges will hold the gear perpendicular to the shaft. And the shaft goes in bearing housings that we also route on the CNC machine. So the long sticks there are the bearing housings. And by making the bearing houses from plywood, we can get a very, very precise distance between the two shafts. So we can make sure that the gears meshes perfectly. So this is me assembling the flanges on the shaft that later will hold the gear. And this middle part is special. It's a key that we can remove and put back on, because for every concert we need to disassemble the machine somewhat. We're building the machine in 7 major sections, and when we're disassembling the machine, this 112 tooth gear will come off every time. We were super happy putting that last screw in, and now we're already trying to fix a better solution. So what's your idea here, Marius?
So part of the assembly should stay on the shaft, so that is centered by the blue core that you can take out and fastened by the screws that go into the green things.
And what if we split? Because these are two layers of the black gear here. Two layers of 18 millimeter plywood.
Yeah.
What if we make them different size? So this blue cover this area. And we don't have that joint. So then the screw will also retain the blue and it will clamp the gear. And so here I'm working on the center key, the one we just redesigned. And I'm putting some threaded inserts into it. We need to be able to pull this thing out with a lot of force. So that's why I'm making the threaded inserts. So we made two big mistakes when we cut this first gear. You see this hole here, where I put my fingers through? That should not be there. What happened was that the downward cutting spiral bit threw wood chips under the plywood and lifted the whole plywood up, resulting in a too deep cut. That was because we didn't clamp the plywood to the work table strong enough. So that's the first fix, to clamp it down. Second mistake was these spokes. They should have these nice ridges here. If you see these ridges, if you see on this spoke, it only has one ridge. And on this spoke, we cut away both ridges by mistake. So we made a new G-code file. I'm gonna recut this gear. And I kind of like this space pattern that comes up on the working table of the CNC machine after some while. And here I am marking the hole locations for the screws that will clamp the plywood more securely to the CNC machine. So the plywood can't be lifted up by the wood chips that are pushed down by the downward cutting spiral bit. I think the machining time for this gear was about 20 minutes, something like that. I think we made it in 3 passes. So the mistakes go on and on and on. We also didn't cut the spokes through. So that was also wrong in the tool path. So, but we think we can manually cut them away and then flush trim. And now you're really gonna see the magic of the flush trim router bit, because we're gonna be able to route this extra edge away, and you will never ever know that this even happened. So this is the flush trim router bit. It has a bearing up here and the knife under the bearing. And the bearing will ride on this surface. That's exactly the shape we want of the wood. And the knife will cut away the wood we don't want. This is my new absolute favorite tool, because it really does exactly what you want it to do. It registers the shape you want and it takes away all the material you don't want. So it's so fun to work with, and it's the perfect tool to remove taps that are left by the CNC machine. By the way, I made a mistake the other day and this gear came off the CNC machine looking exactly like this. I think this is exactly what Bob Ross means with we don't make mistakes, we only have happy accidents. I have named him Wilson and he has already started to talk to me. He's mainly complaining. Anyway, I get sidetracked by Wilson. We are going to talk about double-sided machining, because we have cut the second gear for the marble ring lift one and it looks like this. So we've cut the first side on this gear and now we want to make a machining operation on the back side. So what we did is that we drilled these 5 holes extra deep. When I remove the gear, you see that we have registering holes here. So I'm gonna vacuum clean them to have them precise. So the CNC machine still has its home point, the zero point, in the middle of this gear. So what I do now is that I flip this gear around 180 degrees. I tap down the screws through the gear into the registering holes of the work table. So this gear is now exactly centered. We can clamp it down and start machining the other side. And these round holes are actually inserts for disc magnets, and that's for a special thing that we will cover in an upcoming video. But it looks nice, I think. So there you can see the front side with the grooves and the back side with the pockets for the disc magnets. And back to the router table for some removing of the tabs. You need to leave tabs because when the CNC machine cuts something out, you don't want the part to just move around or shoot away. You need the CNC machine to hold the part, so that's why you're leaving the tabs, and then we can remove them on the router table. So here I'm putting the gear onto the shaft that me and Marius assembled earlier. And that's Hannes. Hey Hannes. Wow, the wheel, without adjustments, the wheel run very, very true. You wanna know a secret feature?
Yes.
So these two holes, this one and this one, they have a metal nut inside the wood. So we can put two screws in like this and pull this center straight out, because this gear we need to remove for every concert. So this gear is attached and detached every night. So if you take a look on the top here, it doesn't wobble almost anything. And we have so far not done any adjustments. So this is typical. I'm super happy with the gear. And then I show it to Marius and he's like, we can do better. All the time.
We can always do better.
Yeah, but I think this is like super precise.
Yeah, it is.
And then Marius comes out and the inner one has a high spot. But that's why it's good you're here, to make everything work. Yeah. But so you still think it's going to work then?
Yeah.
Okay. I was sweaty there. This plywood piece is determining the distance between the shafts that hold the gear. It looks like we have been thinking correct. So here I'm tapping some threads for some M8 screws, and tapping threads in birch plywood is really strong connection. If you're just a little bit careful when you tighten the screws, to not over tighten, they will hold forever. Wow, this really feels right now, finally, after 2 days, Marius. 2 days on this part. Why does it have to be that hard? But now it feels so right. It just goes on there and we can pull it out with the gear puller. This one was the old part. And this one is the new part. It took me seriously 48 hours to go from here to here. I don't really know why, but I messed up a lot of things. And anyway, now it's good. So these shafts with the keyways are specially ordered from a mechanical workshop in Uppsala, Sweden. And it's such a huge upgrade if you compare to the first machine. On the first machine I was using threaded rod for shafting, and to have real 20 millimeter precision shafts, it's a pure joy. Like when you give this wheel a spin, it just runs. So we have 4 bearings on this shaft now, 2 on each side, and that also gives a little bit extra stability of the movement. It's really smooth.
One more time.
Well, we need to work a little bit on it. It doesn't sound so good yet.
No.
It's going to sound maybe better, we don't know. Maybe not.
We'll see.
We'll see. You say that to everything.
Yes.
We'll
so
see.
Skeptical of everything.
Yes. So we now have the second part in place. We have the frame and we have the 112 tooth gear. Next week we're going to show you how the marbles are going to defy gravity in the Marble Machine X. Thanks so much for watching and see you on the next Wintergatan Wednesday.